now invite Dr. Anita Choudhary for her presentation. Dr. Anita Choudhary has done her MBBS from ACPM Medical College, Dhule, and MD Physiology from BJ Medical College, Pune. She worked as Professor and Head Physiology in Sri Aurobindo Institute of Medical Science and Research, Indore. At present, she is posted as Professor at Adigadi Medical College, Ujjain. She has teaching experience of 16 years. She is Organizing Secretary of IYS 2012 and a very active aspirant of Ujjain Yogalife Society. She will speak on the effect of 8 weeks yoga intervention in chronic rhinosinusitis. Dr. Anita Choudhary.
Good afternoon. With due respect of chairperson and co-chairman, I'll presenting a scientific paper as I am associated with medical college. This is a short work we have done. In this paper, my co-authors are Dr. T.S. Choudhary. He's MBBS and ENT surgeon, and our sir has guided Pandit Radheshyam Mishra sir for this paper. Now, this paper is effect of 8 weeks yoga intervention in chronic rhinosinusitis. Now, before that, I will tell what is rhinosinusitis. In the rhinosinusitis, it is a chronic inflammation of the nasal mucosa and the paranasal sinuses. We have different type of sinuses which are present around the nose, that is, they are the maxillary sinuses, frontal, ethmoidal, and sphenoidal sinuses. And due to some precipitating factors, they get infected, then the person suffers from sinusitis. Now, chronic rhinosinusitis basically occurs due to incomplete treatment or resolution of an acute sinusitis, and it is common in all age group. Now, what happened basically in chronic rhinosinusitis? The nasal mucosa and the sinus mucosa, they show inflammatory changes. The mucosa, it becomes very thick and swollen. As a result, the passage gets blocked. The infection damage the cilia, which results in impaired drainage of the sinuses. And when the sinuses are not properly drained, the infected remain in their sinuses, getting more and more chronic infection. So retained secretion leads to reinfection and reinfection. The patient land up with chronic rhinosinusitis. Now this is just the picture that we can see, that showing the maxillary sinusitis, the blockage of the cilia, the normal not functioning of the cilia. Now, what are the clinical features? Now, how such patient present with us, usually they have chronic cough. And this cough, when we talk about the chronic, it has to be more than 3 months. The commonest complaint is severe headache, rhinitis, nasal obstruction, post-nasal discharge, and abnormality of smell, and sometimes they get blood from the nose, that is epistaxis. Now, how we diagnose? Basically, the diagnosis is made clinically with the help of X-ray of paranasal sinuses. The sinuses, they show the hazy appearance. All sinuses are hazy. Sometimes fluid level can be seen. The CT scan of the paranasal sinuses are done, and sometimes proof puncture is done. Nowadays, it is an obsolete method. Basically, what they used to do in the proof puncture, the needle was introduced, and if there is a pus, they take out the pus and they send it for the culture sensitivity. Now, what is the treatment? The conventional medical treatment of this chronic sinusitis is local and systemic decongestant and analgesic to relieve the symptoms. Sometimes and many times, they have to use the broad spectrum antibiotics. Now, this is one of the very drawback of the chronic rhinosinusitis, because the patient has this disease for number of months. And if taking antibiotics, they land up with the antibiotic resistance. The chronic rhinosinusitis patient usually need the surgical approach, that is, enteral puncture is done, the sinuses are washed out, and the sinuses cavity are made clear. So looking to all this, we decided to have the study to investigate the effect of 8 weeks of Jalaneti and Brahmi Pranayam and want to investigate in terms of clinical and radiological score in patients suffering from chronic rhinosinusitis. Means we wanted to see that it has effect, but how clinically it is giving that effect. So we have planned the strategy. We have taken 34 patients of 14 to 32 age. They were enrolled in the study. They were given diagnosis of chronic rhinosinusitis according to the criteria which is described by the Chaprio and et al. This is the patient which we have selected. We have stopped their treatment for more than 15 days before the beginning of the study. The study was improved by the Institutional Review Board of Adigadi Medical College and Ujjain Yogalife Society. And the informed consent was obtained from all the patients before entering into the study. The severity of disease was measured by the two clinical score and one radiological score. The two clinical score was the cough score and the post-nasal secretion score. They were measured at the beginning of the study, once a week for the 4 weeks, and 1 month after the end of the study in the clinic. The radiological score was performed only in the beginning of the study and 1 month after the end of the study. Now these are the scoring system given by the Chaprio for the severity of the disease. We have labeled the patient as a score 1, 2, and 3 depending upon the severity or the symptoms. Like for the cough scoring, score 1 with no symptoms, score 2 with mild cough only at night, 3 with moderate cough at night and day, and 4 with severe cough during the day and also disturbing the sleep. In the same way, the nasal secretion score was given, 1, 2, and 3 with no symptoms till the secretion become purulent, that is infected. Radiological score, normal maxillary sinuses for 1 score. If we see mild thickening of the maxillary sinuses, score 2, moderate thickening, score 3, severe thickening, and complete opacification, score 5. We have taken both the sinuses, the x-rays, so in the result, we have from 1 to 10 scoring. Now, on what basis we have selected the patients? We have selected the patient who has history of cough for more than 4 months, nasal secretion on physical examination, and the confirmation of sinusitis by our radiological rating scaling 4 or with scale 5. Only those patients were taken which have the radiological scoring of 4 and 5, means moderate to complete opacification of the maxillary sinuses. The severity of disease was measured by the two clinical score, again more than 3 or equal to 3, and the PND score more than 2 or equal to 2, and the radiological score more than 5 or equal to 5. We have to exclude some subjects or the patients. We cannot include them in the study just because of some reason. For example, they were having, one of the patients was having mucocele. Now mucocele is not, it is the cystic swelling in the nasal mucosa. So this patient we have not taken in the study. The patient with anatomical defect, we have not taken. The patient who was showing the sign of bronchial obstruction in the beginning and during the study, again we have stopped experimenting on that patient. The patient who had fever during the study and need of medicinal treatment during the study. So taking care of all this, we have excluded some patients. Now patients were randomly divided into two groups matched by age and severity of the disease. Group 1, we made to practice Jalaneti and Brahmi Pranayam and for daily for the 8 weeks. Group 2, we 15 patients for the group 2, we only advised them to instill 10 drops of the normal saline 3 times a day. We had 36 patients. Out of this, only 30 patients could have completed that study. The procedure was kept very easy because they were the general patients. Under the guidance of Pandit Radhesham Mishra sir, we have done this. And just a lukewarm saline water which was cupped on the palm was taken and from the one nostril, and it was taken out from the mouth, keeping the other nostril closed. and this procedure was repeated. Now Brahmi pranayam was chosen, that was in sitting position, to put index finger on the ear cartilage. The patient were asked to take deep inhalation, gently pressing the ear cartilage. While making out exhalation, they have to make humming sound like a bee. Breathe in again, and this was continued pattern for 6 to 7 times, and this was done to do 3 to 4 times a day. So this was the course that was given for the patients for 8 weeks. Now these are the table showing that the results of the cuff score. As I told you, we have taken this scoring system, we have statistically calculated the symptoms, and we have found the results of cuff score, results of PND score, nasal secretion score, and the result of radiological score. Now how we have calculated the score, the difference of the score between the two groups as measured before and end of the study were calculated using the pair t-test. It was found that data was significant and the probability p-value of 0.05 or less was considered as significant. We were focusing on the probability value, and the results what we got were most of them have improved cuff score system, again p-value less than 0.01, improved post-nasal secretion, means patients were giving us clinically improvement in the cuff, in the secretion, and also in their radiological findings, which we done after the 8 weeks. So significant, what is the scientific basis of this Jalaniti? What exactly it has done? It has cleared the nasal passages. Secondly, it increases the mucociliary clearance and ciliary beat frequency. As we know, it was because of decreased cilia movement, and because the cilia are not moving, it is not draining the sinuses properly, but after practicing this, the mucociliary clearance improved and the beating also increased. It also makes the mucus thin and decreases the inflammation. The scientific basis of Brahmari pranayam, humming creates a sound vibration that increases the air movement between the sinuses and the nasal passages. Now this was found to be very beneficial in the patient with sinusitis, because this ventilation inside the sinuses, the air movement also opens the ostia, which usually get blocked during sinusitis. It allows the proper drainage of the sinuses. It improves the ventilation of sinuses, prevents settling down of infection, because if the drainage is proper, the infection will not settle down.
Kindly conclude in 1 minute.
Yes. So, along with this, we have found a various number of benefited in the patients practicing both the procedures. So, to conclude, practicing Jalaniti along with this is a Brahmi pranayam, twice a week improves the clinical and the radiological status among the patient with chronic rhinosinusitis. Such practice of yoga is inexpensive and safe when done under proper supervision. As Jalaniti, daily nasal irrigation shows an overall effectiveness in reducing the symptoms of sinuses in 70% of all our patients, along with they can be used as an adjuvant therapy for the treatment, along with the allopathy treatment, it can be used very safely as an adjuvant therapy. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Choudhary. Thank you so much. Let us give a good round of applause to the presenter as well as the chairperson and all the audience also. It was really an academically profoundly interactive session.